They bolster faux vanity and hold a white supremacist scope over black men and women, often highlighting negative attributes and downplaying mind-expanding ones. They serve as bottomless, coward consumption pits and digital, audio, or otherwise slave mentality museums at all you want, end quote. I don't know what the hell Lakeith Stanfield is talking about, but
I know you don't know what I'm talking about, and that's clearly evidenced by a lot of stuff you say in this video, but I'm gonna let you keep going.
I know myself, Charlemagne the God, in the 9 years I've been on this Breakfast Club, I strive every day to be the perfect balance of ratchetness and righteousness, all right? There's not another show out there that goes from Byron Allen to Black Youngster like it's nothing, all right? You tell me a show where the guest list goes from the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan to 21 Savage. This show has gone from me talking about sucking farts out of women's asses to me encouraging brothers and sisters to go to therapy and invest in their mental wealth. You know why, Lakeith? Because that's life. And that's the way life works, okay? I'm not going to sit here and act like we've gotten it right all the time, because we haven't. We've made plenty of mistakes on this radio, plenty of things I've looked back on and said, yeah, we should have played that a certain way. And all that critique is fine. But Lakeith Stanfield, don't you ever fix your raggedy-ass mouth to call the author of Black Privilege, because I truly believe it is a privilege to be black, anti-black, okay?
Okay, I'm going to try to get through this without using ad hominem attacks and silly little things about your own personal life, because I don't think that's really what we have to hear. We have to the issues and topics at hand. Now, you just illustrated that sometimes you bring good guests, sometimes you bring bad guests. And that's kind of what I hinted to in the subtext of what you just read. Basically, what I was saying is outlets like yours have a tendency to lean toward highlighting negative things. And that's true. And if you don't understand that we engaged in a war, that it's a war to be black in this bitch, that means if you ain't on the team moving things forward, then you against the goddamn team, period. So if y'all doing more of that bullshit, then that shit goes under the umbrella, which I will admit is a generalization, but the umbrella of anti-black. And that's what the fuck I'm talking about. We're going.
Ask all those white people who call up here every day complaining about me saying cracker ass cracker or mayonnaise are asking me why everything got to be black and white. All right. Ask them. Okay, if I'm anti-black, don't ever fix your mouth to call a brother like me anti-black, because Young King, I know for a fact you don't take the chances that I do every day.
Okay, whatever the fuck that means. But also, I never called you personally anti-black, but I can see why out of everybody you might be the most offended one on the goddamn show. You know, but I never pointed you out. I said the platform as a whole, all three of y'all.
It's all right. That's exactly why you didn't call out any white media outlets, because your publicist, your agent, and those Hollywood executives you work for would have had a fit. You would never take that chance. See, as a black person, it's safe to go at black outlets like Shade Room, World Star, Lipstick Alley, Breakfast Club, and many others, as you said, but you would never fix your mouth to say that about any of the white outlets that do the same damn thing. Because
I'm focusing on the outlets that I tend to frequent and the ones that are predominantly are dealing with what we consider the black thing. You know what I mean? Those are the ones that I'm really focusing in on, hunting on at this particular moment. But that don't mean that I don't critique others. You may not hear that. You may not see that. But I critique all kinds of things. It just happened to be that this was on the list in the menu today. To suggest that, you know, I'm not going against the other one. I mean, first of all, that's not my preoccupation, because I know what the fuck they gonna do. But I expect more from y'all. My bad for me holding you up to a higher standard. You know, let me back the fuck off, because I hold you to a standard to not diminish your own people. You feel me? Like, what the fuck are you talking about?
That would affect you in Hollywood. So who's the real coward? Okay, who's really got the slave mentality? If it's easier to call out your own black people than it is to go at the others, white folk. Lakeith is one of these folks who be on red carpets and they don't even speak to black outlets, okay? Walk right back.
Not fucking true. I don't know where you got that information, but not true.
Baller Alert or Bossip or Jasmine Brand, and go talk to E or people, as if those outlets don't report so-called negative stories, as if those outlets are any less messy, okay? Lakeith, I think it's hard to get the character Andre out of your spirit, because it sounds like you may still be in the sunken place, but I'm not about to go back and forth with you about this. I'm going to simply say, when you are on any of these platforms, or even when you are on your own platforms like social media, how about be the change you want to see in the world? Don't give these platforms negativity to reinforce, because all we can do is provide the platform. The artists provide the content. It's been plenty of people who have sat in this room and elevated the conversation in this room.
Okay, we provide whatever the fuck you're talking about. That's a simple cop-out. That's not taking responsibility for the kinds of things that you conjure up. You can clearly control the dial on your medium because you've done it before when it was in your interest. But when it's not in your interest, you don't. When you're talking to certain people, you do certain things. When you're talking to other people, you do other things. That's why I said you have the tendency. I didn't say you do it all the time. I said you got the tendency because you do.
Vibration in this room. You said that these platforms highlight negative attributes and downplay mind-expanding ones, but when you get the opportunity to speak, do you do that, King? I remember when you came on the Breakfast Club and I asked you about the name of your...
Okay, he's gonna bring it to Morris. But before we get to this Morris shit, the moment I walked into the Breakfast Club interview, it was very clear to me that I was dealing with three people that were interested in playing idiotic games with me and not getting down to talking about anything of any substance. And it was evidenced by that interview, if you go back and look at it. I already knew who I was dealing with. So therefore, I put the goddamn grill in my mouth and I acted accordingly, just like I do in many of my interviews, which we'll get to later. But I knew what I was dealing with, so why would I go into explaining to you what the Moors are and what it means to me when I know you ain't trying to hear that or listen to that any goddamn way? You don't give a fuck about what the Moors mean. You give more a fuck about bringing up my goddamn record, which is what you proceeded to do. Again, messy bullshit, the kind of shit I'm talking about. But go ahead.
Group the Moors, that for you to teach, to tell us about the African conquerors of Spain, all right? To possibly tell us about Moorish civilization. But do you remember your answer? Now, the name of your group is the Moors. Is that the original Moors, black Africans, they threw the world?
Fabric of the universe.
I was on.
Gotcha.
Yeah. Where was the mind expansion of that? Where was the mind expansion when you was on IG rapping lyrics with gay slurs? Remember that? Remember when he was letting the F word fly? Play that.
Boy, you're dressed like trash. You were 8'6". Take that choke chain back. That's some gay shit. Only black rags in my cab like I'm racist. Bag, I don't really like to brag, but I'm straight rich. Fuck them bitches out the ass and I'm famous. And all these gay niggas mad because they hate this. Coming through swerving on a nigga like I
Now look, you know, I've said things that I regret.
Now, I admit that that was insensitive, and I've since addressed it. And, you know, at the time, to me, it was really about wordplay and playing with an aspect of understanding that I don't actually hold. But I ain't going to go back into that because I've already talked about it. But, yeah, we've all said things that we address and look back to now and say, you know, I could do better and be better. That's all I'm asking everybody to do. Why are you getting all in your feelings about it? It's not personal. It's just a thing that's asking you to reflect and look at yourself and try to be better. I've had to do it. We all have to do it.
Use language I regret, so I would never be that kind of hypocrite, but I'm just playing that to remind you that you haven't always been this woke warrior you claim to be, okay? In fact, you apologize for that freestyle. You know why? Because you know Hollywood don't play that. They will blackball your black ass in a minute. They will cancel you so quick that the only outlets who would accept you and still embrace you is ha ha.
No, I apologize because that's how I genuinely felt. I'm not going to say some shit I don't feel. I apologize because I didn't want to offend people, but I didn't realize how much reach my social media had at the time. You know, sometimes it's kind of difficult to know how much reach you have, you know. So, yeah, that's why I apologize.
The black ones.
And also, the black ones embracing me when I'm down and out is bullshit. I mean, you don't even embrace me while I'm here sitting in front of you. You know what I mean? So let alone let me be in a down and out and compromised position. No, you won't embrace me. You'll do the very thing that you do, which is to try and trample on people. I don't know why that's your forte, but it is.
It's just so crazy to me. You talk crazy about black outlets, but when you come on the black outlets, it's not like you being this intellectual beacon of light. Okay, he was on Breakfast Club talking about being sexually attracted to dogs. Remember that?
I mean, here we go.
Yeah. You got a Snoop fan.
I ain't gonna lie, you funny though.
Like, looking at the Doggy Style album and being young and confused and not knowing whether I was sexually attracted to the dog or like what I should. I'm starting to look at dogs weird.
Are you
now?
So what I'm talking about is when I was a child and I saw the Doggy Style album, obviously, like that was designed to arouse some sexuality in people. It's not like I'm saying that I was literally attracted to dogs. And by the way, it's irrelevant to the argument anyway. So keep pushing.
It happens. But you go on Jimmy Kimmel and you're respectful. And you bring the white man flowers.
I was respectful
to y'all. It really is.
Thank you very much. It's a magic jacket.
It's a Magic Johnson jacket or it actually has magic powers?
It brings things into third dimensional space that weren't there before.
It does?
Yes. Like flowers, for instance.
Are you going to do a magic trick? Wow.
Aw, took the flower off your jacket and just gave it to the white man. Lakeith, you was getting in it.
Gave it to the white man. What the fuck does that have to do with him being white? Like, just because I gave him... So if it was a black host that I gave the flower to, what would that mean? I don't understand. You know, you might have got a flower. All three of y'all might have got a flower. Had you just simply been a little bit more cordial and, like, you know, decent to me, but you weren't. You know, like, I just gave a flower to a host of a show. It's not about him being white. So don't try to conflate that to fit your own narrative that you're trying to build very weakly, by the way. Trying to build this narrative that I somehow pandered to white shit and I'm against black shit. Like, come on, chill, bro.
For that Netflix project, Death Note, and you was on there barefoot while the white man was interviewing you, and you was sniffing your feet and licking your toes. This is a literal video. What? He was sniffing his feet and licking his toes. Let me hear.
I did not see that. That's disgusting.
You choose.
Okay, so because I do some shit for a quirky role that I was playing, and I was playing an interview of Quirky as I played in your interview, and yeah, I lick my feet. I don't care. They my feet. I love them. There ain't no problem with it. I lick my feet. And you can be tolerant or intolerant to that. But again, what the hell does it have to do with the topic at hand that we're talking about? Absolutely nothing. It's attempting to try and paint me in a light that's not credible because you got no real arguments. You haven't even addressed none of the arguments that I really talked about yet, other than trying to talk about your therapy book, which I guess maybe you need to do a little bit more therapy so you have some clarity and insight into looking into yourself, man.
Seemingly political roles that have
Atlanta, and he's on there sniffing his feet and licking his feet in front of the white man. But it's the black platforms that are the feeding grounds of negative reinforcement, okay? And sniffing your feet and licking your toes, what you call non-conforming. I don't know what got into you yesterday, King, but watch your mouth.
Well, non-conforming would see, the way that you responded to this, that's what I'm talking about. The way that you responded to me doing things that are, in essence, completely harmless and got nothing to do with nothing. But like, oh, whoa, that's like that type of shit is what I'm talking about. You have no space for things that you don't understand. You, just because you ain't comfortable to be in your own skin and do what you do, literally and otherwise, be in your own skin, just because you ain't comfortable with that, doesn't mean that I need not be comfortable with it. I can give white, black, blue, or otherwise men flowers and feel completely fine about it. I can lick my goddamn toes. I can suck my toes until this motherfucking salt up off of them and feel comfortable about that, you know? And I hope that everybody can feel comfortable with themselves to do what they want. You ain't got to do what I do, but I'm not going to be sitting back judging you for what you do all day either. That's what I mean. The no tolerance zone for anything you don't understand.
You call it a black man like me, anti-black. And I always remember when you no, point a finger at someone else, point three back at yourself. Because based on your logic and the things you put out there, you are just as much a problem as you claim us black media outlets are. But Lakeith, I wish you the best. This came from a place of love, and two takeaways I want to leave you with is one, be the change you...
So yeah, I just wanted to address a couple of them things. I just got off work, so I got a little bit of time, but it's just like, you know, you got to do a little bit better than that, man. Just be honest with yourself. You ain't got to be honest with me. You know what I mean? I don't really give a fuck like that. I'm just posting some shit on my Instagram, you know. But I'm sorry that you had to be offended by it. Hopefully, you know, you could kind of see the truth in it. I know I ain't always perfect on my critiques or all the way around, you know, but you know, I really mean the best. I mean good. I mean for everybody to just do a little bit better to, you know, siphon the kinds of things we put out about ourselves, you know. And that's really all I was trying to do. It may have been a little abrasive, but yeah, you know, I just wanted to address a couple of them things because that shit was crazy. But anyway, I'm going to take my ass to bed.